I've got children, we got.
Well, I'm so glad that hospice is honoring him, because it's just he's such a strong person in the community. The love really, really,
really is the. He had the foresight and the vision. I think that's what you're talking about, foresight and vision, to take a product and grow it and improve it and make it better and better each and every year. Let's start drifting away.
Leave all our problems. He doesn't come in and say, look at me, here I am, and I'm the big shot. And no, it's just, he's just Bob, and that's just the way he is, you know, that's who he is. It's time to spread
the love all over the world. He's a prince, truly. He is a prince of Elkhart.
He's a caring person. He cares about the community. He cares about people he works with. Lift up one another.
Shine a light from every heart. Well, Bob is a giver. You know, he looks for every opportunity to get involved and to say, how can I pay back?
Bob Deputy.
Bob Deputy. Robert Deputy.
Well, I met Bob Deputy many, many years ago. Bob is a generation behind me, as you know, and he's a generation that followed me. And the first time I met Bob as a young man, immediately liking him. And he wasn't a show-off, but he just had he had all the stuff. You know, they all lived together in one house, and that's, you know, six boys is a chore, but Mrs. Deputy can handle it.
But we kind of grew up together, if you will. Bob's a little older than I, and Bob's always been a mentor to me in watching him do his business and grow his company and take it from the small little thing it was, and started small and ended up big and just did a great job along the way.
Bob and I met for lunch at McCarthy's, and much like Bob is inclined, he was incredibly insightful and yet warm and gracious and friendly and nurturing. So that is the way that I met Bob.
A group of us were trying to bring South Bend and Elkhart closer together, because actually the air doesn't stop, the county line, and we had to make a conscious effort, because for quite a few years they were very divided, and which was a shame for both communities. And he and our DCO were very involved in that.
Well, it was interesting. I first met Bob online. I was actually abroad in Greece when I had my first interview for this job, and I did it by video. And so I first met Bob on video.
Bob Deputy.
Bob Deputy.
Bob.
What is not to like about Bob Deputy? You just see him and you just gravitate toward him, because he has a positive energy that just makes it so easy just to be with him.
And anybody ever met Bob Deputy couldn't become a friend of his. Something wrong. Something wrong. I never met anyone in his class in Elkhart, Indiana.
One thing that comes to mind that I remember, Bob comes in to this meeting, or ahead of the meeting, and he goes back, and he had a shirt on, but he said, okay, well, I got to go back and put on my tie. I said, Bob, you don't need to. Oh, he says, yes, yeah, he says, I do. He said, Mr. DCO is going to be here. And he says, Mr. DCO wants to see people dressed properly. And he says, and I'm going to be dressed properly. So I got a kick out of that.
Well, great sense of humor. And he always kind of said, and I'm a big fan of boats. I'm a boater, and Bob, not quite so much. He always felt that boats were to be built and sold, not necessarily used.
Part of it is he's been involved with this community for so many years, he and his family, that again, I think that their goal in life is to give back to the community, and I think he's doing that. And that's what this organization is about. We're here to take care of people. And I think Bob does the same thing. He's here to help people.
He's a workhorse. If he came to ask you, do you think you could raise $100,000 for such a thing? You'd say, yes, I could, because it just gives you that enthusiasm, that push. You think you can do anything that he asks you to do. He's just wonderful. He's great.
Bob Deputy.
Bob Deputy was one of the co-leaders of this venture of IU South Bend into Elkhart. You know, we had had a non-permanent home for the university there for any number of years.
And so we always needed a building for these programs. And they put it in rented buildings, different places. Different people had different ideas. It never worked. I mean, we got the courses done, but it was always in a place he couldn't find. It needed to be downtown.
At one time, they were actually right next door to an Italian restaurant, so the students in the classes would be smelling this wonderful Italian food and maybe not paying enough attention to their classes. So Bob and Art Dicio, Jack Citadine, other leaders of the community really worked on finding us a home there in Elkhart.
The mayor gave us the property. It was sitting there, it was empty.
And then really worked with the community to get the $4 million together in order to build the building and have a permanent home in the city of Elkhart.
Bob and I co-chaired it and raised the money along with these 10 associates of ours very quick. And we were gonna make it the size it's supposed to be, but we raised that much money. When we're over our goal, we just put the extensions on right away.
So now IU South Bend is IU South Bend and Elkhart because we have a permanent home there downtown, which has served hundreds of students a year. Bob Deputy.
Fun guy to play golf with. I don't think he's ever hit a golf shot that he really likes because, you know, unless it goes in the hole, it's not good.
Bob and I played a few rounds of golf together. You know, he could work harder on the range, and mechanically, probably Tom would have some fixes. But Bob makes the most of what he brings to the table. And much like the rest of his life, he doesn't take it as seriously.
I have seen him play golf, and he's probably on the same plane as I do. Obviously, when he plays golf, he's probably still thinking about work. So, but beyond that, I'll let it go. He probably has a better handicap than me.
He was a good businessman, but and I think being a good businessman is fine. I was that, but that ain't the biggest thing in someone's life. Being a family man, taking care of your children, and being a good citizen of the community, and Bob had that.
Had a great deal to do with the Lerner renovation. He's got a lot to do with the renovation of the North Main Street area where his family home has been, and the Ruthmere and the Beardsley the complex. Because he's just a committed person.
But think of the things he's done. He's just taken such joy in working with, making the whole area better, because when you have a community such as Elkhart prosper and be better, why, it makes South Bend and all of us better people.
He's one of our heroes. He's one of our role models. His generosity and charity, as well as his character and his humility, set a tone for Elkhart that is remarkable.
Well, I think the importance of having people like Bob, Art, Jeff, and others is they want this community to continue to grow and to flourish. And they have, I think, as much as anybody, have indicated that they have received a lot from the community, and it's their intention to give back to the community. And I think through their efforts, not only do they give to the community, but they teach others to do the same thing.
Stay the same as you are, Bob. You are perfect. There's an ad on the television now. Perfect. He's perfect. He's wonderful. We love him.
Well, Bob, you know, respect you very, very much. Consider you a very dear friend. You and MP and your kids have been an important part of my wife and family's life in Elkhart, and I hope that we can do this for many years to come. You're a very special person in my life, and we love you guys. Best of luck.
Bob, when I grew up, I hoped to be described in many ways that I've had the privilege of describing you. As a godly man, as a faithful husband, a proud grandfather, a proud father. Thank you for your friendship and your embrace of my time here in Elkhart.
You've got your friends, your family around you, and people who really do care about you. And the things that you've done for this community are immeasurable. So on behalf of Elkhart General Hospital, I would like to thank you for everything you've done for us as an organization and for Elkhart as a community.
Well, congratulations, Bob Deputy, on this very well-deserved honor. I'm sure that you take this in all humility, and much love from IU South Bend to you, Bob.
Robert, you're one heck of a guy, and I'm so glad that I've had the privilege of working with you being able to know you and for your leadership in the community. And just, oh, one more thing. Go IU!
Bob, I love you. You are special. I told you that many times. You don't like to hear it. But I'm glad you came my way. And I had the time I had with you all these years. And I hope I'm here just to be able to talk to you and visit with you and love you the rest of my life.
Candle lights must be the season when those love rides.